I'm John Pearson, a botanist with the Iowa Department of Natural Resources, and I'll be showing you two plants today that you want to avoid because they're poisonous to the touch, poison ivy and yellow parsnip. So I have some poison ivy right behind me here, and one thing that I want to point out right away, this is growing as a big shrub form. Now a lot of times when you see it, it'll be a creeping vine, creeping through the grass or creeping up the side of the trunk of a tree. Here it's growing in a shrub form where there's no trees next to it, so it'll form its own shrub-like habit here. So here are some of the characteristics. We have I'm gonna pluck off one leaf here, and I'm wearing gloves, I'm wearing long sleeves, long pants, so I don't need to get exposed to it. So this is one leaf, has three leaflets. These three leaflets, the two ones on the side called laterals, have very little, a very short stem attaching it to the petiole, the rachis, and the terminal one has a much longer stem attaching it to the rachis. So that's one thing to look for poison ivy is the two sizes of the leaflet stems. Now ordinarily on poison ivy in a shadier location, these lateral leaves would have a little thumb sticking out. This one has a very small one right there. But when it's growing in full sun, you may not always see that extra little thumb as when it's growing in the shade. So that's something to be aware of. It does vary in appearance. So this is the poison ivy leaf and leaflets. Notice it's got kind of a shiny upper surface. It kind of glistens in the sun when I flip it back and forth. That's very typical. That's the oil, the irritating oil that's on top of the leaflets. It's also on the interior of each leaflet, but it makes it shiny on top. It actually has little green berries on it right now. Those will turn white later in the summer and fall, but it has these little berries. They're poisonous to people as well, in terms of touching, but birds love them. One more thing I want to point out here, you see it's full of galls. These are little red galls caused by a mite. So these are mite galls growing on the poison ivy leaflets. Now these don't kill the plant, unfortunately, in some people's estimation, but they do disfigure it. And it seems only fitting that a plant that gives a rash gets a rash of its own. So the second plant I want to show you today is wild parsnip, sometimes called yellow parsnip. It's a plant right here in front of me. And you can see it all behind me here too. The entire road ditch going down for at least a quarter mile is just absolutely full of this plant. So what we're looking at here is it's fairly tall. It's 4 to 5, and sometimes even 6 feet or higher. These are all 4 to 5 feet right here. It has these kind of dull yellow flowers, which are nearing the end of their flowering season right now. Soon they'll start to turn kind of a reddish color and then start going to seed. If you do come in contact with it or poison ivy, just get to a place where you can wash off with soap and water as soon as possible, preferably within 1 hour, and it'll minimize or prevent the irritation depending on how allergic you are. And these are leaflets. So there's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and one on top makes 12 leaflets. This is very typical of poison parsnip. The other thing to look for, the stem is grooved. You can see there's a high point and a low point, and a high point and a low point built into the circular stem itself. So watch for those ridges and valleys on the stem to help identify it as yellow parsnip. Yellow parsnip has a compound in it called furocoumarin, and the furocoumarin substance is what causes the irritation on your skin, especially in the presence of bright sunlight like today. Bright sunlight causes the fumarin to break down into smaller components, which are actually more irritating than the intact molecule by itself. And so beware of it in all conditions, but especially on hot days, especially on the hot days if you've got a lot of exposed skin on your arms and legs. Once you're able to identify it, you have the ability to avoid coming in contact with it. Or if you do come in contact with it inadvertently and recognize it after the fact, you'll know to clean off your arm and your skin as soon as possible when you leave the scene.